And we have Speed. I'm here with Danny. We're with Ecential Robotics. And this is Danny, and he's going to show us how cool this robot is.
Sure. So, like I was saying, last time we saw each other, there was no collaboration. Now since then we're collaborating with different spine implant companies. So Spine Wave, Spine Art, and Choice Spine. Eventually they're going to be, you know, they're making their instruments to be compatible with this robot. So you go into a hospital and they don't have robotic capability already. Now each doctor could use a different spine implant every single day, but also have robotic. You know, they don't have to have a Mazor and a Globus and all different kinds. This one is a truly open platform. Registration process is easy. We do a 2D, 3D spin. After the spin is done, this phantom comes off. Patient tracker goes on and you're all set. You're ready to go. Move over to the left side. Instead of sitting there waiting forever to move it nice and slow, this white button will bring you, do gross movements, get you right to the spot that you want to be in, and then fine tune it with this green button. I'm not moving it myself right now. It's going to where the robot wants to. Foot on the foot pedal, and then we're ready for instrumentation. As you're putting instruments, sometimes you're laying on the anatomy. So if I press on this pedicle right here, you'll see that the robot tracks.
Keep doing that.
So this is what we call motion compensation. So patient breathing, or if any kind of instrumentation that's pushing on the anatomy, it's going to compensate for that. And so wherever it shows on the screen is where you really are. Same thing when you're doing a 2D, 3D spin. Because of the technology that we have and because of this phantom, you don't have to stop respirations. So when you walk out of the room and do a 45-second spin, you don't have to stop the patient from breathing. It's nice. Now we want to move over to the other side. Double click. Get it over to around about the right area. And once again, green button. And then you see how fast it was. You're ready to go. Put the next screw in. The workflow moves just that fast. You know, it's not just here in the demo. I'm from one side to the next side, and you're just placing screws, and nobody wants their surgery to take longer, right? And then if you add in any technology, a lot of times that usually equals more time in the OR. But this, ultimately, when you get it down pat, which is easy to learn, easy to teach, it's, you know, everything goes faster.
The advantage to the patient is obvious with most robotics. It's about accuracy.
Sure.
The advantage to the surgeon and to the facility is what in particular with your, what's the novelty of your robot versus everybody else's?
Okay, so not robot, it's in general. In general, obviously, you know, patients love to have, to know that you're using that technology. Ours in general, I would say, is the decrease in workflow in time in the OR. So you, from the time you do the spin until you're navigating, you know, it's a couple minutes. You know, you do the spin inside the OR, you plan the screws inside the OR, and then in 2 seconds you saw how quick it was for registration. And that's literally what it is. You take this one off, put this patient tracker on, and then you're ready to navigate. It's that, and then the process of stepping through our software, it's very intuitive to teach. Do that X-ray spin, and now you're ready for planning. Move these screws around, gross movements like that. Get it right about close where it needs to be, and then use this D-pad to zone it in, nice and easy. You want to walk down the screw, walk down the pedicle to make sure you're in the bone. Right like that, and then hit, if you want to change the screw size, nice and easy right there, hit the check, and then what? Now you're perfectly good to go, hit the play button, and then you're ready to move on. That is the whole process. It seems simple, but, you know, it's because it is, you know, and then you don't need somebody over here pressing the buttons or you telling them where to go. You can, you know, you can control that from the from this side, you know, with those two buttons on the robot. So, I mean, that's...
How are you handling training?
Let's say I'm a surgeon. I'm working out of Cincinnati, whatever, right? What's the steps? I want to bring this into my facility. I've talked my partners into it. What happens next?
Well, first things first, we get you in a cadaver lab. You know, well, actually, the first thing, we have a great, we call it the Institute in Grenoble in France. So it's a mock OR where we do a live demonstration on not a cadaver, but on just like a sawbones. And we have the whole OR set up. We have cameras focused on the patient. And we have a little bit wider of a view. That screen right there is actually showing the facility that we have. So first we would get it, you know, on, do a Teams meeting and just show it like that. And then next thing we would do is go out and do an actual cadaver lab wherever in the country so they can actually do it on an actual specimen. And from there, it's above my head as far as pricing and as far as getting...
But yeah. And let's say I were to get one of these. I talked my partners into the... We all, co-share a surgical facility, which is becoming more common. And I've got an idea for a surgery I want to see as a program offered on your robot.
Mm-hmm.
Is that possible?
You now say that one more time.
Let's say I'm a surgeon and I want to make sure I want to put a program in this robot.
Oh yeah, an application for your own.
Yes, an app. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So if the surgeon does, then what they need to do is say, okay, who do you work with? What do you work with for your spine implants that you like? You know, is it right now? Is it Spine Wave? Is it Spine R? Is it Choice Spine? Is it Sentinel Spine? Whoever it is that you prefer for implants, now you go to the whoever's going to make that decision for that company, and then we get together, and then that company will design an application and all the software and then the instrumentation that's going to, you know, fit in our end effector. And then from there, it's just time and money.
In 5 years, do you think your robot's going to run more apps than any other robot?
Applications as far as being an open platform, absolutely. We already have right now, so it's Spine Art, Choice Spine, and Spine Wave. That's in the first year, so you know, it could be, who knows, by 5 years, it could be every, you know, implant company that's out there potentially. You
how
know,
long does it take to finish an application for start to scratch?
About a year.
Okay, so I see what you're saying. So I can cradle it with this one. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
It gets to the spot a little bit easier, right?
It's interesting how comfortable it is. Yes. I guess, you know, it looks like it's going to be heavy.
I mean,
so
you know that twist is just like a little bit of strength in the wrist, like a man, and then it goes.
This thing, how does it, so this like lays on
so air. So it's...
Is that magnetic?
This is magnetic, which is nice because if you're in the middle of a case and this gets bumped off, no big deal. You don't have to come and do another registration, another spin. Yeah. You just pop it back on. And if it's in your way, you take it off for a second and then put it back on.
And then
no
what's
problem.
This green thing do?
So green does the fine-tuned movement. So see, you already know how to use it. So from anywhere you are, I'm not moving it right now myself. I'm just pressing these buttons.
I see.
You're at where
so
you need to
the
be.
So the robot's like... putting itself where it wants to be.
Correct.
Okay.
It's a collaborative robot, so you know you can either control it. When it's red, it means that it's either adjusting it's not where it's supposed to be. When it's back on green, now you're good. And you can move it like, you know, there's, you don't want to move too fast, but it's still tracking.
That's pretty trippy, dude.
Yeah, so.
Wow. Okay, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, it's happy right
so
there.
So now you want to go over to the other side.
Yeah.
Double click.
Okay.
And then I either will just bring it over quick. You know, you can do it with one hand.
Okay.
And then...
And then let the robot
hold the green. Now just keep holding it until it goes green. And then foot on the switch.
Okay.
Foot on the switch. Now let go of that. So right now you hold the green again until you're in the spot. Until you turn green. Now foot on and stay on.
Okay.
Now you're using your instrumentation.
Like when it's not moving too fast, like let's say I was leaning on the patient, you know.
Yeah, then you could move the entire patient, and as long as it doesn't go too far or too fast, it's going to track it.
Oh my God, you're going to save so many surge techs and PAs getting yelled at by a surgeon with this. It's not even funny.
Yeah, absolutely. And if and
so, this is like a tool going in here.
Yep, that's an awl. So it'll go. Instrumentation goes in.
Just pop.
You're the first open source surgical robot I've ever heard of. Are there others that I don't know?
I do not believe there's another open system. I don't quote me on that. I don't think so.
You might be right. I don't know.
Yeah,
actually,
I'm pretty sure there is not.
Any partners coming on in the future that we should know about?
There are more on the future. I can't name the exact ones.
All right.